A Utah County man is accused of stealing 19th century Mormon photographs and trying to resell them. Kevin Schuer also owes hundreds of thousands of dollars for duping rare item collectors. And as ABC4's Andrew Reeser reports, the 29-year-old could face serious jail time.
Schuer's accused of brokering sales of old scriptures like this Book of Mormon and this old hymnal and then pocketing the money.
The message was clear from Brad Kramer's business partner.
I have a really bad feeling about this kid. I don't trust this kid.
The owner of Writ and Vision Rare Books in Provo was told to avoid 29-year-old Kevin Schuer at all costs.
Do not buy anything from him.
But Schuer came to Writ and Vision trying to sell old photos.
Rare 19th century photographs.
But it turns out, according to an arrest warrant, some of the photos that he had been selling were stolen, including a signed picture of LDS Apostle Orson F. Whitney taken from the campus of Utah State University, and a photograph of Joseph Smith's bodyguard Porter Rockwell taken from the Harold B. Lee Library on BYU's campus. This, along with a lawsuit against Schuer, in which a local collector claimed he brokered big sales of historic Mormon items like an 1837 Book of Mormon, an old Doctrine and Covenants owned by Emma Smith, and a Bible from 1614 owned by King James himself. The lawsuit accuses Schuer of pocketing the money, a total of more than $500,000. Writ and Vision's owners say they tried to warn the collector community about Schuer, who's now being compared to notorious Mormon artifact forger Mark Hoffman, who killed two people in 1985 to cover up his crimes.
I think it's a comparison that has real limits. Kevin is neither a particularly skilled forger or a violent psychopath. Some of the stuff that he was pushing was pretty impressive.
And Kramer says white-collar crime like this can really scare off potential buyers.
Every transaction that he's participated in with every dealer that he's ever participated in now is, you know, potentially suspect.
We checked jail records, and as of this afternoon, Schuer had not yet been booked into the Cache County Jail. Reporting in Provo, Andrew Reeser, ABC4 News.
BYU police arrested Schuer back in October, and according to court documents, found tens of thousands of vintage photos he had snapped pictures of on his iPad for the purpose of replicating them and reselling them as originals.